This is Ashton Marcus, and I'm on location at the Ruskin Group Theatre Company for the world premiere of Sneaky Old Time.
Hi, I'm Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI 88.9 FM in Irvine, and I'm with
Paul Overstreet.
Great, and could I have a brief bio of you?
A brief bio,
you know, what you've done.
Oh, gosh, well, I don't really like to talk about it. That's a little bit embarrassing, but I've been in country music a lot and written songs for a lot of country artists, and I had a recording career myself, and so this is a new adventure for me in the theater, and I'm loving it. It's so much fun, and I'm using a lot of the songs we've written and had hits with through the years. So.
Right, yeah, actually, you're being extremely modest. Didn't you win, like, 2 Grammys?
I did, yes. So I was fortunate, very fortunate.
Yeah, a Dove Award, and a couple of other multiple awards.
Yeah, several ACM awards, and actually a lot of whatever the country music gives out, you know, CMA awards, things like that.
Okay. Well, one question I want to ask you is, with the theme of this play is it possible to have a significant relationship, get married, and actually have a successful career?
As a
musician?
Oh, yes, absolutely. Yeah, nowadays if you do it and it works well, I mean, if your craft takes off and people respond to it in the way you want, you can have a really good life that way.
Yep.
Especially as a writer. I think as an artist, it's a little tougher because you're gone a lot, but as a writer, that's what I love about being a writer, is you kind of have your own life. You can, when you go to a town, you can go there just for enjoyment. But if you're an artist, you go there because you're going to work there, you know.
Well, okay, another question I have for you. What is the success you've had behind music? Because you're outstandingly successful for the genre you're in. So, I mean, any kind of tricks of the trade you could give to, say, younger musicians?
Oh, gosh, I think perseverance is probably the greatest thing. Don't ever give up. Because a lot of times, there were times when I thought I was just going to have to go do something different. And right about that time, something would happen and a spark would happen. And I would get encouraged and stay with it. And I think that's one of the big tricks, is just persevere.
Okay. So another question. Why did you decide to do something like this? Why did you decide to get into musicals?
I've worked on several before, one in New York, kind of on and off for 5 years, and then it kind of didn't develop like I wanted it to. Another one I worked on with a couple of other guys, but they didn't really have all the parts to put it together. But I knew about it, and I knew how to do it. I just had never really got the wheels underneath it, and so I've been looking for the opportunity. And when I met Yonta, she was bringing in an element that we hadn't had before. And so she's one of the producers, and she and I are co-producing with Mike and the Ruskin. And so she brought that element that made it all come together and work.
You'll actually like this performance a lot.
Oh, good. Thank you. I'm glad you got to come.
Yeah, and actually, I see a lot of the trends, like Motown. They're taking music. There's American Green Day. The Green Day band is bringing it. Mm-hmm. And also, again, ABBA with Mamma Mia. So there's kind of this trend where there's actually taking mainstream music and making it into musicals.
Right. Yeah, I've seen a lot of that. And Carole King actually had one as well. The one thing I wanted to do different was I didn't want it to be about any. I wanted it to be a fictitious story, and I wanted the book to be stand on its own. And I think that Steve Mazur has done a great job with that. He's just created the story, and it's so fun and so entertaining. And weaved it with the songs and used them in the right places. And it's just really amazing.
So basically, this was a story about your life.
Nope, not at all.
Okay.
Thank God.
I like the story a lot because it was a very well acted musical. It's very, very well performed, very well written. And again, it shows it's when I was doing research on you, I actually saw all those songs. These are actually very popular songs that you wrote.
Right. Yeah, they've been very successful, and the artists that sang them, a lot of thanks goes to them because a lot of them were at their peak when they recorded some of these songs, or are on their way up, you know, and so we were fortunate to get to work with them and have them be part of it too.
Okay, another question, seeing as you help produce this thing, I assume you're involved in the casting, right?
Yes.
Okay. What do you look for in your casting?
you look for the answer. And you know, if I could tell any actor anything, just don't be nervous. All we're looking for is somebody to solve that problem. We're looking for this character, and all they have to do is come in and be that. And we're pulling for them. We're not sitting there wanting to judge them or criticize them. We're wanting them to be that thing. And so it was fun. It was really, sitting in that chair was different for me. It really gave me an insight to that.
Well, thank you very much for being on the show.
All right, thank you. Thank you for coming.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine, and I'm with?
Steve Mazur. I wrote Sneaky Old Time, the book for it. They went with Paul Overstreet's lyrics and music.
Great. So why did you decide to do something like this?
Well, it was a great opportunity to work with one of the greatest songwriters of all time. So who wouldn't jump at the chance?
But still, you could have written anything. Why did you write this particular piece?
I love the Ruskin Theater. I personally love musicals. And again, I mean, you can't do better. I mean, I honestly started at the top working with Paul Overstreet. So, you know, it's just a great opportunity. No writer would pass it up.
Okay, well, again, I assume no writer would pass it up, but again, you chose this particular thing, because I asked basically Paul.
Yeah.
This was not based on his life. So you made this thing up. So what was in your mind? I mean, why do you want to communicate this out to the world, this story out to the world?
Well, I listen to all of Paul's songs, and a lot of the music is about the tension between sort of being young and fancy free, but also the joys of commitment. And so I wanted to try to come up with a plot that would help explore those two ideas and let them butt heads. And that's how I came up with this idea. It's four characters who are really just one person battling with himself, trying to figure out what's most important in life.
Yeah. And also, can I have a brief bio of you?
I'm a screenwriter. I wrote Liar Liar and The Little Rascals and some TV movies. I also teach screenwriting and improv at AFI, the American Film Institute. And that's basically, I got a wife and two kids, so I can relate to the story myself, yeah.
Okay, that's another question I've been asking a lot of the actors around here. Is it possible actually to work in showbiz and have a successful marriage?
Well, there's a lot of long marriages in this company, including Paul, who's been married, I think, for 28, 29 years. Robert, who plays Red, he's been married about the same time. And I just had my 29th anniversary myself. So, yeah, it's certainly possible. Yeah.
So what's your secret? I mean, because even if you're a writer, still you have to meet people. You have to meet them face to face. You just can't do all your work over the phone. I mean, so that's a lot of hours you got to spend face to face with other people. So, what's your secret?
You know what? Honestly, a writer, at least my kind of writing, because I'm usually working on screenplays, I'm in my office day after day and don't meet a lot of people. So, part of the reason why I love doing stuff here at the Ruskin and any sort of theatrical thing is to get out, meet people, make friends, and so I've really enjoyed that aspect of it. And this company is very close. It's an ensemble piece, and so that's been a really great side benefit. Made a lot of friends in this show.
All right, well then, any kind of advice you can give to, say, younger screenwriters out there who want to get into the business?
Well, you got to have perseverance. That's the main thing. So you just got to keep plugging away, plugging away, plugging away. I have found working in theater as well as film that to be really invigorating. So I advise that as well, you know. Keep dipping your foot in the water, and you know, if you stick with it, very frequently something good comes to pass.
Well, I love this performance.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Thank you very much for being on the show.
Okay, I really appreciate it. Thank you, sir.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine, and I'm with...
My name is Dave Florek. I lived in New York for about 12 years. I've been on Broadway, up Broadway, series regular on Grace Under Fire, and 2 years on The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, Nickelodeon series, a regular, TV movies, plays. I've been doing it a long time. I played the old man.
Yeah, I liked your performance. Yes, it was kind of a little touching, in a way.
Well, it is. I thank you for that. He's actually quite funny early on, but his arc takes him to where, when he realizes that the young Jack Welling may not be with this gal, he remembers his own life. And then, of course, he sings the song, Sneaky Old Time, saying, don't blow a chance when you have it.
I was actually impressed by your singing, too. Are you a professional singer also?
No, actually, I'm not. I'm not really a singer at all. But if there is a kind of music I can sing, it's what Paul Overstreet is writing.
So, seeing as you have so much experience in acting, my show is actually listened to by a lot of community theater actors.
Oh.
So is there any kind of advice you can give them to help them get along on their way?
What I have told many, many people over the years, because I've been around a long time, if you want to be, I say to anybody, be an actor if you can't not do it. Okay? Meaning, it's got to be a passion, and you need to have to do it. If you're in it for any other reason, I would suggest you look at something else.
One more question I have to ask. In the theme of the play, mm-hmm. How do you keep a stable relationship, a marriage or something like that, when you know there's so much work and so many people have problems with that?
Well, I've been married 36 years, and I think that for me, it helped that my wife was an actress years ago, and now she's a writer, and so we understand the ups and downs, the perils, and the good things of this business. So you're much more forgiving, and it's not a typical road. So if you just realize that it's going to be a trip into Wonderland, like Alice in Wonderland, then you'll be all right.
Oh, well, thank you very much for being on the show.
Thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Ashton Marcus with KUCI 88.9 FM in Irvine, and I'm with
Robert Craighead. I went to the American Academy of Dramatic Arts. I grew up in Texas, and I grew up loving Paul Overstreet music. Played the role of Red. Red is a good old boy who at one point wanted to be a country music singer and kind of gave up on it in order to make a success out of himself and get married. And I've been married for over 20 years, and now all of a sudden my wife and I are having some problems. And so I'm sitting in a bar drinking and thinking.
Going with the theme of this this musical, is it possible, you being an actor, is it possible actually to have a happy family life and work in show business?
Well, I've been married for 30 years, so and we're very happy together. So I think it works out great. Yeah.
I mean, but it's so demanding. First of all, you have to be at a lot of places. You physically have to be there. It's not that you call in. I mean, is this very challenging to be married?
Well, actually, it's like this year I've been on location. I was just in Florida last week, and Northern California. I go all over the place, but it makes for the time that you spend with your loved one more quality time. So I think it works out great for us anyway. Yeah.
Well, you know of a lot of people, obviously, in Hollywood where it didn't work out, where they're on multiple marriages, where it seems like a problem. So is there any kind of advice you can give to younger actors who are thinking about being married, maybe getting into show business? Do they have to choose between the two?
Well, I would say the biggest advice I could give is don't think too highly of yourself and think that you've got to go out and party all the time. Be true to your work and be true to the one you love. If you feel the need to go out and go to all the clubs and everything, you think that's necessary, it's really not. I mean, because it's the work that speaks for itself, you know. It's not the partying.
Well, I loved your performance.
Well, thank you very much. You guys are a fantastic audience, man. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for being on the show.
You bet, man. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine, and I'm with
Chip Bolsik. This is my third play at the Ruskin. I spent many years doing voiceovers in New York and decided to be an actor again. Came out to L.A., and I'm doing plays now. Play the repairman, Fyodor Kostya Stanislav Abrankovich Yegorov, Jr. Fyodor is a Russian immigrant. He is a jukebox repairman. He's a specialist in it. In Russia, everybody knows how to fix these old jukeboxes. In the U.S., almost nobody does, so he came here to start a new life.
Actually, I liked your character, and I liked the act. I always like the actors who are kind of like these. They really have to act, you know. Because even your singing, you were singing in character.
Yes, yes, and dancing in character too. Hopefully, it's. I specialize in accents. I do many of them, but Russian is one of my favorites. So I actually brought that to the show. They were going to have it be a Mexican American, they liked what I did, so they got a Russian guy instead.
Yeah, did you do voiceover work?
I do. Yeah. I do. I've done voiceovers most of my life.
Yeah, I hear that the voiceovers, they actually emphasize that a lot. I mean, not only do you have to be able to do an imitation of somebody, you have to be able to act in that voice.
Yes, you must be the person. You can't do an imitation. You can't do a caricature of the voice or of the accent. It has to be the person. So that's what I'm used to. So hopefully that's what came across tonight.
Yeah, well, I liked your character. Because, again, I thought it was very, very light, very funny, and also very complex in certain ways.
Oh, thanks. I appreciate you saying that. Yeah. He's madly in love with Janine, who runs the bar, and this is his third time coming to fix her jukebox, and he never quite fixes it because he's trying to work up the nerve to ask her out. That's his whole thing, this is the woman he wants to marry.
Okay, now, can I ask you, seeing as you have so much experience in acting, is there any kind of advice you can give my audience? Because a lot of them are community theater workers, and they've been working for a long time, and they can't get a break.
Okay.
Any kind of advice you can give them?
Well, I mean, we're at the Ruskin Group Theater, so it's going to sound like I'm plugging the theater. I'm actually plugging the school. There's a school associated here, and they do Meisner technique here. And for me, it has changed my life. I did a 2-year program at this school, and it changes you from being a lot of community actors that I've seen are very broad, and there's no depth to what they're doing. But if you go through a 2-year Meisner program, nothing you do on stage is false. It's always real, honest, and immediate in the moment. So my advice is take a 2-year Meisner program. It doesn't have to be here, but it changed my life, truly.
Yeah. If you take these types of classes, do you actually do a lot of networking, too, with actually real working artists?
Yes, you do. One of the joys of this particular school is they get a lot of casting directors to come in, agents to come in, and they watch your classes when you do performances. And then you have the opportunity to be in these shows. You know, this is a world premiere musical that, you know, who knows where it's going to go. It could head east to a little city, you know, on Manhattan Island. And that is an opportunity that you don't get at every school. They have a great theater here. This is the second original production world premiere that I've done here, and my third show, as I mentioned earlier. And you don't get those opportunities just anywhere in Los Angeles.
Well, thank you very much for being on the show.
Pleasure talking to you.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine, and I'm with
Amy Mata. Well, I grew up in Phoenix, Arizona. I went to Arizona State University, theater major, and came out here maybe 18 years ago. I've been in LA a long time. I play the bartender, Janine. She's running a bar on her own and going through a little bit of a rough patch in life, but kind of depends on the people that come into her bar as her family.
Yeah, and do you have a musical background too? Are you a professional singer?
No, I'm not. I'm a professional shower and car singer. So this has been great. It's been a lot of fun to sing in this.
Yeah, actually, I was really impressed by the singing of everyone in the cast.
Some great voices, unbelievable voices, and such different voices, right? Different tones by everyone and just different styles, but all perfectly suited for this.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Also about country music, it's strange that in country music, it's all about the lyrics.
It is. They tell the story, right? I think more than any other genre that I've heard, the lyrics of a country song are telling the story. They are as important to the script as the actual script, right?
Yeah. Actually, because one thing I do is, when I was earlier, because I do a radio show, mm-hmm. when I first started out, they made me do like OPI reviews. I had to review songs, and we do a lot of alternate rock songs. So when I was listening, I could barely hear the words on the song.
Sure.
But I have to do it, otherwise our station could get fined. So I went through some software to filter it out. I listened to the words were terrible. I don't mean they're profane.
Yeah, right.
I mean they were just amateuristic in a real bad way.
Yeah, I can see that. Yeah, I'm actually a huge like heavy rock fan. So there, I get that. I mean, I hear a lot of that, you know, and I like different kinds of music for different reasons, for sounds or mixing or whatever. But yeah, I've never come across a genre that's this much based in storytelling. Yeah.
Yeah, well, I'm surprised again that you didn't have a musical background, because again, it was just very difficult for me to tell which ones had the musical backgrounds and which one didn't.
Oh, thank you. Well, great. I mean, I sing a lot. I love to sing. I grew up listening to, like I said, a lot of hard rock, so I would sing that a lot, very like operatic and very, you know, big voices. So, yeah, that's my background.
Okay, yeah. And also a question I'm asking everyone is, seeing as you've been in the business so long, is it possible to actually have a successful long-term relationship and still be successful in the show business?
Personal relationship? Oh, yeah. I'm married for 3 years. We've been together for 10. I am, yes, extraordinarily happy, and it's a great relationship. Yeah, it gets better and better.
Yeah, but a lot of other people haven't been very successful, you know, multiple divorces and all that.
Yeah, I hope that's not my case. I can't speak for anyone else, but I'm very, very happy. Yeah, he helps me in my life and my career, and yeah, he's a huge support of mine.
Why do you think so many people have so much problems in relationships and so when they're working in show business?
Gosh, I don't know. I mean, maybe some of it's logistics and not being able to be in the same place at the same time, but I don't know. Maybe some of it's that. Some of it's picking the wrong person or picking people for the wrong reasons. I don't know.
Yeah. Do you think it would be possible, say you as a woman, if you married an actor and he said, you know, we're going to have a marriage and all, but you got to understand acting is always going to come first to me. If I go to New York, I'm going to be in New York, even if we don't see each other for 3 months. You can come back and fly, but I got to be there. I can't turn that down. What would you say, something like that?
Well, I guess it is a matter of priority and perspective. I mean, to me, my husband comes first, always. But he's not the kind of person that would say, you know, you can't do this. He's so supportive. So there really is never an issue, because anything I want to do, he supports, and vice versa. If I had to go to New York for 3-5 months to do a movie, he would say, great. We're going to get a lot of frequent flyer miles. So, you know, it's not a problem.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for being on the show.
And thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine. And I'm with?
I'm Alexander Hitzig. For the last few years, I've just been playing music on the road. And then I kind of got called in last minute to be a part of this project. I was back on the East Coast, spending some time back there where I'm from in West Virginia. And I got called to interview and audition for this show. And I ended up, I guess, making the cut, so here I am.
I was very impressed by your musical talents.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. So basically, are you more of a musician who can act or an actor who can sing?
Maybe a little bit of both. That's kind of like, you know, when you go to the Dairy Queen and you get a swirl, you know? Chocolate vanilla swirl.
Yeah, but actually, usually when I see actors like you, I kind of know that you probably studied music for a long time when you were very young.
I've been playing music since I was about 13, and experimenting with instruments before that, of course. But I started getting serious when I was about 13, and played guitar for about 8 years. Started playing fiddle when I was about 21, and now I'm 31. I've been playing music professionally for the last 7-8 years. Or more. And
when did you start acting?
I started acting. My first show was with the Greenbrier Valley Theater in Lewisburg, West Virginia, when I was about 8. And I was Edmund in The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. You know, that was, I was super young. But, you know, I kept with acting for a while back east, and I always loved it. And then I just got more into the music, and I just wanted to maybe just concentrate on the music, because I was kind of like torn between the two of them. So I figured one or the other for a while, concentrate on one thing, get it really, really good. And I decided to go with music. And then this opportunity came up to be a part of this. And for the last few years, I've kind of been wanting to get back into acting, so, because I'm passionate about it, you know. Hey, I've got to go. I wanted to finish by just like saying, it is an absolute honor and a pleasure to be working with everyone in this whole cast. The directors, the people producing it, the writers, the musicians that write, the everybody, the actors, the musicians playing all the music, the stage managers, everybody. And you know what? I haven't been acting for over 12 years, maybe longer. And I kind of dove into the deep end with these guys. And it's because of these guys that I'm able to just be a part of this. And their talent has brought me up to their level.
As a musician, I sometimes have to ask you a question like this. Do you sometimes think it's unfair that an actor comes on, he's singing, and you know very well that you're so much superior of a musician to them, but the way they do it is they act their way through the song. They smile. They get all the words right. They get all the tunes correctly and all that. But you kind of know that, I mean, you know, what you did was very hard becoming a musician, practicing all the time and all that. But they're more acting through the song opposed to really performing it. What do you think about something like that?
You know what? I think that maybe there's a balance, you know? I think that for someone that acts full time, maybe they come into a situation like that and
she was there just like that in the morning.
They do their best at music while they're doing what they're really good at, or vice versa. A musician comes in to do acting and you do your best at acting while you're doing what you're really good at. And then, you know, maybe everybody finds a common ground with enough time and work. And I think that's something that in Sneaky Old Time, we're right there, man. And having a band that's as talented as the band that's playing with this show, you know, it gives room to act more, you know. And I know what you mean, but also, you know, for someone that's not a musician, like, apparently, several of the people that are actors in this show are not musicians. Imagine having such a good voice and such an ear and not being a musician. I think, like, being able to sing that well, you are a musician, because your voice is an instrument, you know, and everybody just uses it differently, so, and we show all our expression through our voice in different ways, so, yeah, anyway, it's a complicated answer, but.
Well, thank you very much for being on the show.
Hey, thank you, appreciate it.
Hi, I'm Ashton Marcus with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine, and I'm with
Lara Jones. I grew up in Evansville, Indiana, and I grew up to a beautiful house filled with music, and I've always wanted to sing, and I went to school for musical theater at Millikan University, and then I moved out here to pursue my songwriting and singing. I play Maggie. Maggie is Jack's girlfriend, and the whole show he is deciding whether or not he wants to propose to her. And when I show up, we kind of have an argument. I want him to, you know, pursue his music, so I don't want to get in the way of that. And we end up kind of working it out and falling more in love and getting engaged. And
so are you more of an actor or are you more of a musician?
I'm definitely more of a musician. I love acting. I went to school for musical theater, so I went to school for this. But I'm definitely more of a singer-songwriter.
That's strange, because actually you didn't sing that much. You did a lot more acting, and I actually liked your acting a lot.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Yeah, I mean, I love acting. It's so much fun. It's always fun to get to play with other people and, you know, bounce off the energy of other people and what they give to you and really listen to the other characters you're on stage with. It's great.
Plus, also when you sing, you don't sing like a singer where you're kind of stiff and you don't know what to do with your hands. And, you know, you kind of...
Yeah, totally. What do I do with my hands? I think it's, you know, the background of musical theater where you kind of learn how to act with your song, you know? Singers only get into that because they think about what they're doing, but it's when you really just let go and act with the song, then it's just, it becomes this beautiful being.
Also, I'm asking a question a lot of people because this is the theme of the story. Is it possible to have a stable, long-term relationship with someone, yet at the same time be in show business?
Oh, yeah, totally. Yeah, it's just someone has to, you know, support you and share your passion and really understand that, you know, sometimes you leave your heart on the stage and that's okay. And to let, you know, other people see who you really are by doing show. And I think if somebody understands that, that's a beautiful thing. And I think it's totally possible.
Suppose you had, you got signed up for a tour and you're going to be touring like the entire country. This tour is going to be like 4 months, at least 4 months. You're not going to see your husband. He's welcome to fly in anytime he wants, but this is so important to you. You know, you can't say no to something like this and still expect to have a career.
Right. No, totally. I think it's a balancing act. I mean, you know, they can fly in wherever they want, and I think, you know, as long as you stay true to that one person, I think if you really, you know, love that person, I think nothing is going to really tear you apart. You're always going to work through it. You know, whatever problems arise, you're going to work through it because you love them, and you know that you'll be back with them, you know, whenever the tour is over. So in the long run, it's only a short amount of time. You know, 70 years from now, you're going to be like, oh, that four-month run was fun. You're not going to think about it.
Well, again, well, unless you're someone like a Paul here, where you're, that four-month run becomes like a 40-year run.
Yeah, that's true. But I mean, Paul's amazing, and he has such passion for what he does, and I really respect that he really dives into these projects, and he's been amazing and such a big help. And I mean, he's taken me aside personally and helped me with my song and, you know, gone through it with me, and I just think that's great to actually be able to sit in the room in every rehearsal with the songwriter and the script writer. I mean, it's something you don't get to do very often, and it's great to help develop a show.
So you think for your feature that you're gonna concentrate on your music, or you think you're gonna concentrate on acting?
See you tomorrow.
Yeah. I think I'll definitely concentrate more on singing, but you know, I always love acting. I always love getting projects that I can do both. But singing is definitely my heart and my passion, and that's definitely what I want to continue doing.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for being on the show.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI 88.9 FM in Irvine, and I'm with
Nina Brissy. I'm from everywhere. My dad was in the Air Force, and I went to college at Pepperdine, and I've been doing regional professional theater since I graduated, and this is my third show here at the Ruskin, and I'm happy to be here. I started with Paradise, and then El Grande, and now this show here. I played Sheila, the barfly. She's the bar's regular, and Janine's very good friend, the bartender. And she's been divorced twice, and she just has had it with men. So she really speaks her mind, and the alcohol really lets her let loose, and she just goes for it.
Well, going with the theme of the play here, mm-hmm. Is it possible to actually have a marriage, a significant relationship, and still be in show business? I mean, I've seen where it didn't work a lot.
Right. You know what? That's an interesting question, because there's a lot of people where it works, and there's a lot of people where it doesn't. So, and I would say that, you know, in entertainment, because it's so highly publicized, the things that work don't get publicized, but the things that don't work do get publicized. So I do think it is, and I've seen healthy relationships in the entertainment industry, and I've seen unhealthy relationships. So I think it's all about how much you try in that relationship, and how much you, you know, put that person as, I guess, first in some ways. Yeah.
So when you look for a significant relationship, are you going to try to say, hey, show business comes first? You got to understand that. I mean, if I got to be in New York for 4 months, you're even welcome to fly over here to New York, but I got to be there for my career. Are you gonna have to have that as rules?
Well, I mean, I think it's a case-by-case basis, and everything, it just has to be looked at case by case. You know, there are things that I haven't taken because I didn't want it to affect my relationship, and there are things that we've said, look, we're going to do this, and we're going to do it together, so we both have to put more effort in when that happens, but it's a willingness on both parts.
Yeah. Because again, I've seen, like you said, I've seen where it did not work a lot.
Yeah.
And again, the theme of this show, I believe, is he's thinking, well, maybe, you know, maybe this won't work.
Right. Yeah. But again, it's the Maggie character, who's Jack's girlfriend, who says, I'm going to support you. You've got talent. I believe in you. And that's what makes the difference. It's so funny. Steve Carell's wife was there for him for how long? 40 years, supporting him through the little bits and pieces and this and that, maybe picking up the slack for him because she believed in him, because she loved him. And that's what makes that kind of relationship work.
Well, I also liked your performance because, again, you played more of a quirky type of character.
Yes.
And I love the quirky type of characters.
Yes.
Opposed to the straight-laced person who's just basically playing themselves.
Right. Yeah, and I do too. I love playing character roles. And that's all the roles that I've done here have been very much more the bigger character, the opinionated kind of character. So it's exciting to me to do that as well.
Yeah. Well, I loved your performance.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Yeah.
And thank you very much for being on the show.
Yes, thank you. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI 88.9 FM in Irvine, and I'm with
Ken Corpy. I'm from Grand Rapids, Michigan. I've been in California for about 8 years. Went to Pepperdine University for acting and directing, and just been trying to do it ever since. I played Lucky. Lucky is a gentleman who's in his 30s. He is a chronically single man who basks in the lifestyle of one-night stands and late-night drinking and hard mornings and all that kind of stuff. And for Lucky, the play is about realizing what more there is beyond that type of a lifestyle.
I have a question for you. Do you have a musical background?
I do have a musical background, yeah. I did musicals all through college. I did musicals in high school a little bit when I was younger. My first musical was Merrily We Roll Along when I was in fourth grade.
Well, the reason I asked you that is I can't quite figure you out because you're such a great actor. I mean, your singing's fine. Your singing's fine and all that. But you can really act a song very well.
Oh, thank you very much. I appreciate it. Yeah, you just gotta learn how to fill it. Those songs, to me, the beautiful thing about musicals is a lot of times when you're singing, it's the things you can't quite express with words. And so it's another way of letting more truth out that you haven't been able to show just dialogue.
Yeah, because there's a lot of musicians out there, outstanding musicians, they just can't act the song. They're kind of a little stiff, you know what I mean?
Sure.
They don't know what to do with their hands when they're playing, if they don't have an instrument, you know?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Yeah, so any kind of advice you can give performers like that?
Advice to give to performers like that? I would just tell people to focus on the inner world and what fills the song and what's behind the words. And you know, I pick images and sound bites from my past to focus on that bring up truth, so that I can feel something in a genuine way, rather than trying to tell the audience what I should be feeling at that point, what the character should be feeling. So yeah, I mean, you learn the song well enough so that you don't have to think about the notes, you don't have to think about the tempo, you just learn it, and then all you think about is letting it go and focusing on your inner world and the story you're a part of.
Okay. Another question I have for you is, with the theme of the musical, is it possible to have a stable relationship yet still be successful in show business?
Is it possible to have a stable relationship and be successful in show business? I mean, God, I don't know yet. I mean, not so far, but I'm sure it's possible. I mean, I've seen it with a lot of the guys in this show, the guys that have a few years on me. There are a good number of stable relationships, really beautiful relationships, yeah. And I think a lot of artists, that honesty, guys like that are in this show, like these guys are so authentic and honest and just beautiful, and I think that type of emotional authenticity lends itself to relationships, to strong relationships. So those types of people in the business, I'm sure, can have gorgeous relationships. But, you know, there's all kinds of people in the business.
So what kind of challenges do you face? What's stopping you from basically finding your ideal, settling down, and just having two kids?
What is stopping me? God, I don't know. I guess it's the woman's fault. No, just kidding. I just haven't found her yet, I guess.
Okay, it's not like the long hours. It's not like you have to work when you're working when she's off. When she's off.
Oh yeah.
And, you know, when you're off, she's, you know what I mean? And yeah. Also you always have to be somewhere. It's like you have to face to face with everyone. Even interviews you have to be face to face and all
sure,
that.
Sure. Yeah. It's the schedule in this lifestyle is bizarre sometimes and unusual. But I think there's a way to do it. There's a way to do anything.
Okay, yeah. Well, thank you very much for being on the show.
Yeah, nice to talk with you.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine, and I'm with...
Nicole Olney. I am 21 years old, in the play and out of the play. I am from a small desert California town in Victorville. I moved to Los Angeles about 2 years ago, wanted to get acting, and I started taking classes at the Ruskin. And I had gotten involved with this particular play almost a year ago at one of the first readings of it. Mike Myers, the director, had seen me in another play and said, I think you'd be good for this part. So I came in and I read for this particular piece and just absolutely fell in love with it. And from the first time I looked at the script, just knew that it was something I needed to do. I played Lexi, sexy Lexi. Lexi is a 21-year-old bartender in training. She at first comes off as pretty aloof and perhaps dim-witted, but she actually is a genius. She has an IQ above 140, and she propels the plot forward by explaining what's going on. And she, just like every other character in the show, has an arc and grows and just becomes a part of it with everybody.
I love the story. I love the play, or the musical. But the question I have, though, is it possible to really be an artist and actually have a stable marriage, stable relationship? What do you think about that?
That's really interesting. It's something that I haven't really decided on yet. I think it is definitely possible. I've seen a few people, not only in this cast, but just kind of in this community, who have beautiful, beautiful relationships. I think it's difficult because with artistry, there comes, your heart pulls you in all sorts of different directions. There's travel, there's different pieces. You're working in very close situations with other people, but I've seen people who have been married around here for over 40 years or even 10 years and are just head over heels for each other. So I think it really depends on the individuals. I think it is possible. I hope it's possible. I think it's very, very difficult, though.
Yeah, because it's like, first of all, I've noticed that in this business, you always have to go somewhere. You have to be face-to-face. You can't do it over the phone. And also, the thing about it is, it takes so much time. You have to travel. And also, the hours you're working are totally opposite of the hours someone else works.
Oh, completely.
If they're working in the daytime, that's when you're resting. When they're off, you're performing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, completely. I mean, I was talking to Rupert, who is Xander in the play, who plays one of the Jacks, his uncle. And he's been married to his wife for over 50 years now. He's been in the business. He's been a director, and she was a casting director. They're both in the business. And I asked the same question. How do you keep moving? seems impossible to me in this business, but he was saying, you know, you go through seasons. You go through seasons where this person is your lover. You go through seasons where this person is your best friend. And you go through seasons where you kind of hate each other, but you grit your teeth and you white-knuckle it through. And at the end of the day, you're with this person who you've just experienced all stages of the world with. And it makes it that much more special that it's difficult. You know?
Well, again, I liked your performance. I liked the play. And thank you for that advice. That was very insightful.
Thank you so very much.
Yeah, you really are a genius. You know that?
Well, one can hope. I don't know if it's over 140, but...
Thank you very much for being on the show.
Thank you very much for watching it and enjoying it.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine, and I'm with...
Mike Myers. I run the theater, and I'm the producer, developer, and director of Sneaky Old Time.
Why did you guys decide to do this piece?
Well, Paul Overstreet called us and said that he wanted to develop his hit songs into a musical, and he had been in London at the Ambassador Theater. And they had sent him here because they came to Sideways. So we met with them and we thought it was a good idea. So I interviewed three writers. Steve Mazur came in and gave us a great idea. And we decided that this would be a lot of fun to do.
Okay, now the question I have for you is, what do you look for in your casting?
Authenticity. Authenticity in a show like this, people that can sing with soul. Because without that, I mean, Paul Overstreet, being in the Country Music Hall of Fame, is one of the best songwriters to ever live. So if you don't have people that can sing with soul, you don't have a show. So for this show, it took us a month and a half to cast it in L.A.
Okay, well, I was very impressed by the show. I liked it a lot.
Good. Thank you. We appreciate that.
Great. So basically, when you were directing this thing, any problems that you faced that you could share with the audience?
You know, when you have a guy like Paul Overstreet that's written so many songs, it was trying to cut songs back. So cutting songs back, not having some of his other hits in the show, trimming the story. I mean, within a world premiere musical, you're always doing trimming and improvements. So, I mean, you know, it was a worthy project, and every job we did was really worth it.
I'm also told that all great directors learn something from every single thing they do. Is there anything you learned from this, from going through this experience of producing and directing this play?
I have never taken this long to cast a show, and doing so really taught me that the value of patience pays off, because this cast has become a family, and they really love each other, and it's really moving. So I learned patience.
Well, thank you very much for being on the show.
Thank you.
See you. Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine, and I'm with...
Cliff Wagner. I'm the music director for Sneaky Old Time. I'm a musician and multi-instrumentalist, and I've been playing music all my life, and I've been here at the Ruskin Theater playing music and building sets for probably about 5 years.
And were you involved in the casting also?
Yes, I was.
So what do you look for in your casting?
For this particular show? We were looking for country singers and also actors, which was hard to find here in LA. But we've found a great group.
Yeah. So is it more important that they're a country singer, or more important that they're an actor?
it was kind of it was six half dozen, actually. We were looking, honestly, I think we were looking for good singers, but not musical theater singers. So we were looking for people that could possibly sing country music and also act. So it was difficult. It was a very specific type of person we were looking for.
Oh, that's unusual. Again, so did you go out of your regular template of how you usually cast plays, musicals?
Well, yes and no. I mean, Paul Ruddy was our casting director, and he has a wealth of people that he knows, and we saw a lot of people. We saw a lot of people that were great actors and not good singers, and we saw great singers that were not country singers, and you know. So I mean, I think we ended up doing four different castings to actually find the right people for this show, because it was very specific.
Okay, another question. The musicians, though. How do you do your casting for your musicians? Because you had a live band here.
We didn't cast for the musicians because these musicians are all guys that I've played with before, and I've been playing in Los Angeles for about 20 years now, and I know several wonderful musicians that play country music and play Americana, and they were more than happy to help me out on the show.
You know, I always ask that question of a musical director, and I always know the answer. It's almost like you got to know the musical director.
Yeah, yeah. You have to go with people you trust. And part of the reason why Mikey had me be music director is because he knew I knew a lot of musicians that I could trust that could play this type of music. So that is the first thing you go with. You know, we didn't have auditions or anything for the musicians. I just picked them myself because they were just all people I knew that could do the job.
Yeah, because I understand why you have to do that. It's because it's so hard doing this job. It's like you got to know the song. You know, you got to know country music. No, you got to know these songs. You got to know these songs. You can't just know any country music. You can't just know bluegrass or something like that.
Right.
So if you were to do it any other way, it would make a hard job impossible.
Absolutely. Yeah, part of the reason that I was chosen as music director because I know this music. And I know a lot of guys that also know this music, and they know Paul Overstreet and they know his songs, and I could contact them. They knew exactly how to play this stuff. So
yeah, so then it's kind of like comes the problem if you're a young musician and you don't know anyone, how do you get the job if you have to know the music director? And you know, you won't know the music director if you don't get a job. You know, what kind of advice can you give to those musicians?
What kind of advice can I give to those musicians for musicals specifically?
Say a young musician who wants to get into musicals like this, and you know, you have to know the music director, otherwise you're not going to get hired as a musician, or at least know someone who knows someone. You know,
right? Well, you know, music is, and this applies to gigs, and this applies to almost everything, is networking. And knowing people and playing with people. Go out there, play with people, and get yourself out there. And then you never know who's going to do what. You know, it is like these friends of mine that I've played with before, and I've played gigs with them around town and out of town. They know me as more of a musician and not as a music director, but then I call them up and say, hey, I'm doing this play based on Paul Overstreet's music. I want you to come play, because I know them. So it's all about networking. That is the bottom line if you're going to actually make that type of thing happen. It's who you know.
Okay, another question. What's it like being the music director when Paul Overstreet is looking over your shoulder?
I love Paul Overstreet, and my goal through this whole thing was to make him happy and reproduce his songs in the way that he wanted them played and the way that he wanted them sung. So as a music director, I wasn't trying to reinterpret his songs. I'm listening to the recordings and trying to create the sound that Paul wanted, because I'm a songwriter too. And Paul is a more than prolific songwriter, and I want him to be happy with how these songs are being played and how they're being sung. So that was absolutely the most important thing for me. And anything he wanted, I would do.
Yeah, it's kind of a little different if, say, we were doing Annie, because, you know, the writer of Annie isn't going to come by here. But
sure.
This Paul was in the audience when you were doing this.
Yeah. And these are very specific songs that he has written, and they have a lot of value for him. And they weren't written as original musical songs, right? These are just songs that he wrote about, you know, times that are happening in his life. And so they're very powerful to him. And so I want, you know, I wanted to reproduce that same power and that same emotion for him and for the audience with these songs. You know, it's like you can't. We're not reinterpreting an old musical of, you know. We're not trying to recreate or reinterpret something that's already been done. These are songs that have specific meaning and specific emotion that we have to pay attention to. And that's that. For me, it was ultimately important that Paul really. And that I was doing a service to Paul as far as the songs. That was the top of my list.
Okay. All right, well, thank you very much for being on the show.
All right, thank you.
Sneaky Old Time will be playing at the Ruskin Group Theater Company from August 1st to September 19th. For more information, go to www.ruskingrouptheater.com or search for AMB Theater, that's all one word, AMB Theater on Facebook.